You know, it's funny. We told you when the Eagles played the Giants in that last game of the season that they'd quit. They'd quit on the city of Philly and quit on themselves and the coaching staff. And how in the world was that offense all of a sudden going to jumpstart itself in a playoff game? The answer is they weren't going to, and they didn't. More concerning, though, of course, is that defensive performance.
Yep.
Because this is the same Tampa team that a week ago, when they needed a win to get into the playoffs and win the division, scored 9 points against the Carolina Panthers and did not get the ball in the end zone. Here's the part of the game that for guys like me, I don't want to speak for you guys, that hate the Philadelphia Eagles and don't like Nick Sirianni, loved. It was the desperation.
Yep.
So it's 16-3.
Yep.
Tampa gets out to a quick start. It's in the second quarter. The Eagles get a touchdown. 16-9. All right, kick the extra point. And offsides, holding whatever it was, so they can move the ball closer, get it to the one, or just take the extra point. Now it's a 16-10 game. And Nick Sirianni decides in that moment, oh, I'm going to go for two.
Yeah.
But there's no benefit. If you're 16-10, a touchdown and the extra point, you win the game. 16-11 doesn't do you any favors because now you need, if it's field goals, two field goals
yep.
to win the game. So you're still a touchdown away in reality from winning the game. That's called desperation. That's called a coach who is so concerned with his offense's ability now to score points that he's going to take points off the board. Fast forward later in the game. They're getting blown out. They kick a field goal. They get a defensive penalty. They take the field goal off the table, creating a 4th-and-5, incomplete pass in the end zone, and it's a wrap.
Ball game.
You saw a head coach yesterday that was desperate, that was insecure, and didn't believe in his team. Those are the kinds of decisions that get you fired.
Yeah, because they struggle against the blitz all day. That's the bottom line. And when you go 0-for-11 on third down, I mean, you're dehydrated. You're just thirsting for something to happen.
Something,
some
right.
type of magical. So that's why you see him pressing that in that regard. And by all accounts, man, we talked about it earlier when we started the show. There was a great opportunity for the Philadelphia Eagles to say to the world, we hear you. Run the damn
Run the ball.
Yes.
Right.
And you didn't, especially the way DeAndre Swift looked like last night. I thought him and Devontae Smith was ready and willing to carry this team and put them on their back, and they pretty much went away. Like, DeAndre Swift had a pretty Devontae Smith had a pretty good game. Swift did as great as he could. But overall, man, it was coaching. It was just, they got out-coached in the worst way. So I'm sitting here saying, if you're the Philadelphia Eagles, man, I don't know how you let Nick Sirianni back in that building.
Yeah, and for a lot of reasons. Not just because they've now lost 6 out of their last 7 games, but because of the turmoil. Because it's clear to all of us, you know, that the Eagle players started tuning out the coaches, and you had a problem in that locker room.
Absolutely, and those are two things that are both very much evident last night. Just this coaching, being out-coached, coaching strategy.
Yep.
I didn't play in the NFL, Willie, but I'm watching the game. I'm like, they're blitzing you on every single down.
But that's what Todd Bowles does.
Every down.
Todd Bowles blitzed damn near 60% of the time. Like, he's going to send pressure. And what's crazy about the situation, too, which what killed me, You have Devontae Smith, and you have a big tight end, and you have guys who can gas you. Obviously, DeAndre Swift in the screen game is a monster. When the Philadelphians went Eagle, Todd Bowles blitzed them out of the slots. Go screen. Throw bubble. Get the ball out of Jalen Hurts' hands.
Anything.
And time after time, Todd Bowles was like, all right, you going to sit back there? I'm going to continue
coming
to see the dogs.
Every time.
And they didn't adjust at all. And I'm saying, this got to be the most mind-numbing football game I've
Every
ever seen in
Every Eagles
life.
Fan's on the couch saying the same thing. And the announcers are saying it into the they're like, well, they're getting blitzed every single time. They probably shouldn't be running these 10-yard dig routes. And they get their head turned around 5 seconds after the ball snapped.
At one point, Aikman didn't know what to say. He wanted to say in plain sight, this is stupid.
Yeah, he's like, bro, I give up.
Yes,
exactly.
Like, he wanted
it was that
like,
bad.
It was bad.
You know, it's funny. A lot of times here, you watch games and you try to convince yourselves that what you see is going to change when you get to the postseason. But there's an old adage where I come from, which is New Rochelle, New York, which is if it looks like a duck and it sounds like a duck and it walks like a duck and it quacks like a duck, it ain't a deuce. It's a duck.
Yes.
This was the Philadelphia Eagles for the last month and a half. So I think part of it was we all kind of mocked Tampa Bay, right? They kind of backed their way into the playoffs. Baker was hurt with the ribs and the ankle.
Yeah.
They scored 9 points against the Carolina Panthers. And then last night, you saw Baker Mayfield announce to the world, I'm getting paid.
Oh, yeah. Right?
And by the way, if Tampa wants to bring me back, it's going to cost them a lot of money. One-year deal, $4 million, plus a lot of incentives. But you saw the comeback player of the year playing like he was playing against children yesterday in Philadelphia.
It wasn't that he just looked great. They looked like a new offense. Like, this is time after time, whether it was Rashid White, whether it was Trey Parker, whether it was the big tight end for the Bucs. These guys, I mean, even Mike Evans didn't have, like, Chris Godwin,
they had
Mike
drops.
Evans, they had drops all over the first half. It was Baker in the pocket dropping dimes. And I'm saying to myself, I know the Eagles are bad, but this is really bad. But also, like, you got Baker Mayfield looking like the next coming of
the Gunny. It was a laser show. Like, it was just on awesome. The line, right into people's bread baskets. And, you know, Mike Evans had a huge drop early. And then Otten had a huge drop early. And Mike Evans had a second drop. And when that happens, we've seen it happen with the Chiefs. They sort of like lose faith in each other and in the offense. Nope, Baker's still dropping back. Dimes everywhere.
But I said it yesterday. There's the will versus want to, right? There's no way you can go into the game and not tackle is better. Like, you got to will yourself. If an opponent's coming at you and you think you're solely in the NFL going to get there with arm tackles and then he's not going to break that, like, it's just peewee football. Your legs on contact.
Two things I thought in this game. Number one, football is a very easy game to play an offense when the defense doesn't want to tackle you. No joke. Like, you know, you're seeing some of the highlights here, and it's just bad tackling.
All
like,
day.
And that's a team that's given up. That's a team that's totally quit. And like you talk about want to, there's no want to in there. And I think they'll be thrilled if Nick Sirianni and Matt Patricia and the rest of that coaching staff is kicked to the curb and a new regime comes in. Well, obviously, we'll get to that a little bit later on in the show. Belichick, Harbaugh, whomever else the case may be. But I actually thought on the very first drive of the game, I'm like, I wonder what Todd Bowles is going to do. Right, because Rashad White looked like he was going to have a big game. And I was like, man, they played right into Philly's hands. After the Baker Mayfield scramble for 7 yards, it was incomplete pass. Oh, they settled for a field goal. And I said, damn it, hand the ball off to White. He was off to a very quick start. And they abandoned it. I'm like, here, Philly's going to come down. I'm going to be all ticked off. And again, I went to bed. It was 32-9. I don't know how the game ended. But when I went to bed, the Eagles were losing. But early on, I was like, man, I felt like Tampa, you know, gave Philly a shot. And then it was very clear, 8 minutes into the game, you know, three drives or so into the game, that the Philly we saw against the Giants, against the Cardinals, was the exact same Philly that we were going to get last night.
Yeah, and like we said it before.
And I love it.
After those two.
I love it.
After those
Matter
two.
Of fact, I'm sorry.
Okay.
Yeah, I got to do it.
Craig's going to finish the 40 by the end of the show.
You're going to want to stay tuned.
Philly, this is for you.
You're going to want to stay
F
tuned.
That, it's safe for Philly.
Who's it for?
This is for my New York Giant fan friends, and this is for all you Cowboy fans who are calling out sick today because of your embarrassing performance.
Off the week.
I got you.
Yeah.
There you go.
Such damn
boy, Craig.
Bottle up. There you
attaboy.
Go, man.
Woo!
Live it up.
Look at
is there anything better in life, I'm sorry, Jacoby,
no problem.
Than when a douchey, arrogant team from Philadelphia embarrasses itself in front of 20 million people? I can't think of anything better.
They didn't just embarrass themselves.
Woo!
I mean, it was – you lost to the Bucks. Like that's,
Craig
that's
said
bad.
Earlier, they scored 9 points against the Panthers 7 days ago.
Right.
Eight days ago, they scored 9 points against the Panthers.
The Eagles were favored in this game by like 4 points because of what happened between Tampa and Carolina.
Yeah.
And a must-win.
Brady wasn't on the field,
now,
man.
Here's what's going on real quick before we take a break. I want you to know this. It's very important. My man right here, Mr. Willie Colon, is saying to himself, man, we just did 19 minutes. We're all on the same page. We're all making fun of Philadelphia.
Yeah, it's great.
We're all saying great things about Tampa. The show's going perfect, right?
Yeah.
What he doesn't know is that after this break, we're going to discuss the Bills and Steelers game.
Oh!
And we're going to toast to Pittsburgh.
Here we go.
And if we can say it together, here we go.
Here we go. There we went.